traditional and unceded Aboriginal territories to the Coast Salish peoples, and in particular the Kaikai Nation, on whose territory we work, live, and play, and whose territory we stand upon. Our first game of the day is the women's bronze medal game between the number 6 seed Capilano Blues and the number 4 seed UFV Cascades. We'd like to extend our thanks and appreciation to the fans who've come out to our gymnasium today. At this time, we ask you to please rise if you are able to and remove your hats for the playing of our national anthem. Now for the starting lineups. From the visiting Capilano University Blues, at outside hitter, number 1, Eva Nagata. At libero, number 2, Vanessa Gatto. At outside hitter, number 7, Megan Coben. At libero, number 8, Brooke Lightburn. At outside hitter, number 11, Daphne Kung. At center, number 15, Kelsey Towers. At middle, number 16, Olivia Humiston. And at middle, number 17, Jaylene Lucas. And now from the home University of Fraser Valley, Cascades. At middle, number 2, Alicia Cooper. At middle, number 3, Sedona Morowski. At left side, number 5, Chelsea Kidd. At left side, number 7, Kristen McBride. At left side, number 8, Stephanie DeMules. At left side, number 9, Amanda Matsui.
Welcome inside New Westminster and the Douglas College Royals campus, the gymnasium here at Douglas, as we get set for the 2020 PacWest Women's Bronze Medal Match between the number 6 seed Capilano Blues in their road blue uniforms taking on the number 4 seed, the UFV Cascades, in their home whites. Good afternoon. My name is Ryan Waters. Thanks for tuning in on this Saturday afternoon from Douglas. These two teams, inarguably the toughest match to play in sports. Toughest match, toughest game, regardless of what sport it is, it's a bronze medal match. Your hopes are dashed the night before in a semifinal. You fall in a semifinal match. Your hopes of winning a gold are now gone. Now you have to regroup, get ready for a bronze medal, and still try to win some PacWest hardware, and that's what these two teams will do here today. The Cascades and the Blues. They met 4 times during the regular season. They split their regular season meetings, each winning 2. How did they get here? Well, the UFV Cascades beat the Cotter Avalanche on Thursday night in a quarterfinal. They lost 12-25, but then came back 25-19, 25-15, lost 17-25, And then they came back to win in five sets, 15-11. Kara Williams will go back to serve for the Cascades, open up this bronze medal game between the Cascade and the Blues. That's Kelsey Towers, the setter. She'll track it down for Nagata. Eva Nagava. It's been a nice story here for the Blues. That one tipped over by Chelsea Kidd. Kung, Daphne Kung, dug there by McBride. Here comes Matsui, dug again by Nagata. And they set up Megan Coven in her final PacWest match. Cascades control, that's Matsui. Gonna overbump Matsui again, but dug by Nagata. What a rally to open up this bronze medal match. Cascade will go to work. Chelsea Kidd just tips it over. Towers has to track it down. Now Nagata from the backcourt. McBride with the pass. Here's Chelsea Kidd, partially rejected. Coven sends it back. Here's Kidd off a block. The libero is there. That being Brooke Lightburn. And this one is going to inside the sideline. What a rally to open up this bronze medal match. So the Cascade beating the Avalanche, then losing yesterday to VIU, 25-13, 25-16, and 25-13. We'll talk more about that match throughout this one. As Kelsey Towers, the setter, will go back for the Capilano Blues. Talk about how they got here in a moment. That one rejected. Matsui gets it, and the Cascade will have to send it over on the free ball. Towers in the middle. This one tipped over by Humiston. Cascades will now send it over to free ball. Can the Blues take advantage? Towers to Kung. Kung a little tip, but Demules tracks that one down. And Matsui will just send it over. Lightburn, a nice pass to Towers. Back set Kung. Kung another tip, but Demules is right there. Back set for Matsui. She tries to tip it over, not going to get it to the net. So the Blues, the sixth seed, upset the number three seed Douglas Royals, 10-25, 25-18, 19-25, 25-14, and then 15-6, and then losing to the number two seeded Camosun Chargers yesterday, 20-25, 24-26, and 25-27, as that one sails long. And the score is 2-1, Blues with the lead. That's setting up this bronze medal. So both teams winning in five sets in the quarters and then losing three straight in their semifinals to set this one up. Here's Towers to Coven. Coven, Matsui with the dig. Up against the net and the Cascade won't get it over. This is for the Capilano Blues. They have been in this match a lot. Sixth straight appearance in the PacWest bronze medal match. They're 4-1 in these matches. Two of those wins coming against, you guessed it, UFV Cascade. In the middle, that is Alicia Cooper. On the floor for the Cascade, that's Cooper going back to serve. Sedona Arabski, also Kristen McBride, Chelsea Kidd, Amanda Matsui, and the setter Kara Williams. Here's the serve, handled there by Brooke Lightburn. And then Coven from the backcourt. Here's McBride, dug by Coven, up against the net. Kung will send it over, and the Cascade will now send it over. Coven has to dig it, and can't quite. On the floor for the Blues, Daphne Kung, Kelsey Towers the setter, Olivia Humiston, Brooke Lightburn, she is the libero, Eva Nagata, and of course Megan Coven. Those are the six players right now in a 3-3 tie. Coven tracks this one down, sets up Nagata. Nagata will send it over, but sends it too deep. And it's 4-3 Cascade. UFV 11-13 during the regular season. 7-5 at home, 4-8 on the road here at Douglas, including the two matches they've already played in this tournament. They're 2-2. The Blues are 9-15 overall. And this one goes off the arm of Nagata, chased down by Lightburn. Can Coven get it over? She does. Nice play by the Blues. Here's Kidd, rejected. Humiston, who has five blocks, now make it six in this tournament, rejects Kidd, the second team All-Star, and it's 4-4. Jadeleen Lucas now into the match for the Blues, and Humiston will serve it. Demules, tough play for the Cascade here, and out of bounds, point to the Blues. Humiston will go back to serve again. Rookie player out of Surrey, Holy Cross Regional. And here she comes, leading 5-4. Now it's 5-5. The Blues, 9-15 overall. They were 5-6 at Cap, 4-9 on the road. On this floor, including their victory over Douglas, they're 1-3 in this gymnasium, 2-2 during the regular campaign against these Cascades. Here's Chelsea Kidd in her final PacWest match as well. Quick set, Lucas will just punch it over. Here's Arabski, she nails it down, the rookie of the year. 3 players in total in this match playing their final PacWest match. Chelsea Kidd, Megan Coven, as I mentioned, but also one of the liberos for the Cascade, that's Cassidy King. She's on the floor right now. The only player in green, and there's an ace. Kidd with an ace. So Kidd and King, the two 50-years for Cascades, on the floor right now. Coven, the lone 50-year for the Blues. There's the serve. There's Towers at the net, feeding Kung. Kung, nice dig, but it goes into the scoreboard. Good effort by Kidd. McBride did all she could do to save it. Couldn't quite reach it. And it's a point for the Blues. It's 7-6 UFV. Back to serve, Daphne Kung. A rookie to Surrey. Sylvan Heights secondary. 13 kills so far in this tournament. Grunt serve, and here comes McBride and sends it too far. Kung trying to put a little extra gas on her serve with that oof, that grunt. 7-7 now. Here comes Kung. And the UFV Cascades will send it over. Coven digs it to Towers. This is Nagata. Nagata down the line, finds the corner and in. Capilano men's team in attendance as well. Perhaps not quite awake yet. Even though it's 12:42. They are university dudes after all. There's an ace for Kung. The Mules couldn't quite get that first pass up and over. And it's 9-7. It looks like the men's Cascade team also in attendance. Yesterday they were here. Somebody brought a recorder, like an elementary school recorder, to try to distract the VIU Mariners. That's who the Cascades were playing yesterday in the semifinal. They had those whistles that were extremely annoying. High pitch, didn't really distract the Mariners. Distracted the broadcaster, though. And then somebody, not only did they bring a recorder, but they brought sheet music. Wraparound for Lucas, she's rejected. Gatto sends it back. Coven with the save, now Nagata. Nagata cross court. Nice dig by Matsui. Back court. Coven with the pass to Towers. Towers with a tip. Arabatsky said no, but the ball's still alive. Arabatsky again, and this time it's down. Arabatsky with the kill. How both teams able to keep that ball alive was pretty impressive. Before Arabatsky gets her 13th kill of the tournament. Here she comes. Kung saves it. Nicely done by Daphne Kung to keep the ball alive. This is Amanda Matsui goes long. And give Kung credit for that point. Able to track it down right in front of the broadcast table. Got it wrapped around the antenna. Kept the ball in play. And then Matsui hit it long. 10-9 Blues. Eva Nagata. Her serve, handled there by Kidd. In the middle, missed time, but Kidd is there to send it over. Gatto, battle at the net, Towers gets it over. UFV controls. Good tip by Matsui. Smart, smart decision by the third-year player. And Cooper will check back in. Nice play by Towers to keep the ball alive as well, but then Matsui said enough is enough. And a nice tip to tie it at 10. Arabatsky back to serve, the PacWest Rookie of the Year. Here she comes. Gatto with a nice pass to Towers. This is Coven. Coven off an arm. And it's 11-10. Humiston will come back in for Cap, as will Demules for UFV. And Jaylene Lucas will go back to serve. Second year player out of Surrey Christian School. And here comes her serve. Handled by Kidd on the missed pass by McBride. And now free ball for the Blues. Can they take advantage? In the middle, Humiston. Doug DeMule somehow gets it over. Kung will get it to Coven. Coven off a block and down. Judging by what I've seen so far in this first set, there's no hangover after the semifinal loss yesterday for either one of these teams. They want a medal. The Blues, very familiar with the bronze medal, as I mentioned, in their sixth straight bronze medal match. Nice tip by Cooper. And King will pop up for the Cascade and come in as the libero, as will Brooke Lightbird. As Lucas will have a seat. 12-11, Carrie Williams will go back to serve. Fourth year player out of Mission. Her serve. Towers will handle the here in the middle, Humiston. King is there with a nice pass. This is a Kidd with a little tip and down. Chelsea Kidd, 23 kills coming into this bronze medal match. That's 23 in this tournament. And Williams will go back to serve, the avid hiker. In a 12-12 tie, here she comes. And it goes wide, a service error. 13-10 Blues with the lead. DeMules will check back in for UFV. And the center Towers will go back to serve. Kelsey Towers, 5-7 from Coquitlam in her second season. Here she comes. In the middle, they're going to give it to Kidd. Kidd off a block. Towers keeps it up. Lightburn will chase it down. And then Kung and Towers weren't sure who was going to get it. Kung took it at the last second and hit it into the UFV bench. Three, 13-all. These two teams met last year in a quarterfinal, and the Blues upset the Cascades. At that time, the Blues were ranked fifth. The Cascade ranked four, like they are this year. Blues are ranked sixth. This is Kung, dug there by King. McBride is blocked, but off the block and out of bounds. And it's 14-13. Just my last thought on the UFV men's team, bringing the recorder and the sheet music. I mean, that's preparation right there. That was yesterday in their semifinal match with the Mariners. I didn't hear the recorder, but a couple of people told me that there was indeed somebody playing the recorder. Here's Coven, dug by Matsui. Back set for Kidd. Kidd a little tip. Daphne Kung keeps it up. And now the Blues will send it over on the free ball. Back set, the wraparound. Arabski dug by Nagata. Good effort by the Blues, but it's down in the Cascade. Get a point, 15-13. I don't see a recorder or sheet music over there. I mean, what kind of sheet music do you bring for a recorder? Mary Had a Little Lamb, I suppose. I think I last touched a recorder or played a recorder in grade 7. 15-13. Ace for Matsui. Second team All-Star this season, and the Blues want to talk things over, down by 3. 16-13 the score. Now after the ace by Amanda Matsui in her third season at a Riverside secondary. Interesting story for Amanda Matsui. She's been terrific, really, in her three seasons with the Cascade. Has led them in pretty much every offensive category since getting here. Total points this year, she recorded again over 300, 320 in total offensive points. Just been a real treat for the Cascade. Cascade have unable to get hardware last year. The year before, however, they won bronze. Guess who they beat? Capilano Blues. Blues, as I mentioned, making their sixth straight appearance in this bronze medal match. I'm sure they're tired of playing for bronze. They'd like to play for gold or silver. That match is designated for the VIU Mariners and the Camosun Chargers later on this afternoon. 5:30, both teams have already punched their ticket to the CCCAA National Championship, which is in Quebec in a couple of weeks. So both teams know that they're going. But still, they don't want to lose to each other. The island rivalry will be alive and well at 5:30 this afternoon. a 1-versus-2 matchup. So after the timeout, Kung handles the serve from Matsui, gets it back. Kung with a little tip, tracked down by King, and now McBride will send it over. Towers in the middle, rejected, but somebody might be on the net. It's a 4-hit charge to the Blues, so Humiston didn't even get it over. Lead now 4 for the Cascade. Matsui back to serve, putting together a nice string here. Here she comes. That serve is going to go too long. Matsui just tied a serve and she wants somebody else to serve. 17-14. DeBeals back in. And Megan Coven back to serve. Coven out of North Vancouver. 227 kills during the regular campaign. Here she comes. They set up McBride. McBride, Lightburn with a nice dig. Here's Nagata, dug by DeMules. Again, McBride, a little tip. Humiston reaches around, keeps it alive. Coven from the backcourt. Dug by Matsui. Now Matsui will try from the backcourt. Off a couple of hands and down, and Matsui gets the point. 18-14. Arabski back in. Lead is 4. And here she comes. That's Cooper with the serve and the ace. And Gatto will swap out Lightburn. Gatto in her second season has a twin sister also in volleyball, also a libero. Back to serve is Cooper, here she comes. And that is an ace right on the back line. You could hear Gatto and Coleman saying out, 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 but it was in and it's an ace and requires another timeout call by Coach Rob Gao and the Capilano Blues. It's interesting with Coach Gao in his first season with the Blues. He was a long time an assistant. Was it Simon Fraser, I believe? Now a head coach with Capilano Blues, and sometime during the regular season, they started wishing Rob a happy birthday to the players, and now before every single match, they wish him a happy birthday. Before today's match, the bronze medal, they sang happy birthday to him. It's not his birthday. They had me on Thursday, they were saying happy birthday to him, so I went over and said, hey coach, in this quarterfinal, happy birthday. And I said, it's not my birthday. And then he told me the whole story. So every time the Blues take the court, it's Gao's birthday. Now, if I was coach, I'd say, yeah, it's my birthday. Hand over some gifts. Or at the very least, bring me a cupcake. Chocolate. None of that vanilla stuff. Some sprinkles on top. Yes, please. And if you want to get fancy, you can put some of that hot fudge in the middle. Anyway, back to action. Nice pass by Gatto. They're going to set up Kung. Kung between the block. Nice dig by Matsui. Here's McBride. Dug by Gatto. Over the nets. And Arabski says that's enough. 21-14. You know, listening to the Cascade coaches prior to today's match, they were really pleased with how their team played against the top-ranked team in the nation, the VIU Mariners, yesterday. And the score was an indicative of how they play. And that will go long. They lost 25-13, 25-16, 25-13. But the coaches, head coach now Rosema and assistant coach Cal Wolford, were talking and how pleased they were with their team, how tough they played. Coach Shane Hyde of the Mariners said it during our postgame chat as well, saying that's the toughest we've had to battle. And again, you look at the scores, you think, well, wait a minute. Arabski will get a point as she skies towards the net out of the middle. Now a substitution as Mueller will depart after her serve and the libero will come in Gatto. But hearing Coach Hyde and also Coach Rosema basically echoing the same thoughts, you have to believe that the Cascade were giving the Mariners all they could handle, despite the score. Towers in the middle. Miscommunication between her and Lucas, or just mistimed, more like it. And it's 23-15 Cascade. And that strong play has now carried over to this bronze medal match, where they're ahead in this first set. And Chelsea Kidd will go back to serve. Kid serve will float over. Gatto handles that one. Push over to Nagata, who tips it. Kid is there, sends it right back to the Blues. They're looking to take advantage. There's Nagata through a block, but outside the boundary line, and it's set point now for UFV. There's another story about Cal Wolford as well. He's a former Capilano coach. Coven with the dig. Here's Kung. Kung, a little tip. Demules, pardon me, King was there. And now down the line, it's McBride, and she ends it. Final score, 25-15 in favor of the Cascade. They take a 1-0 lead in this best of five women's bronze medal match. We'll step aside, be back with the Blues and the Cascades. We'll go to set number two next to the 2020 PacWest Volleyball Championship. To set number two we go after the UFV Cascades strike first with a 25-15 victory in that first set over the Capilano Blues. Take a 1-0 lead in this bronze medal match. Some stats to pass along. The Cascade were led by Arabski. She had 4 kills. Cooper had 3, as did McBride. Matsui, a couple of kills as well. As far as the Blues are concerned, 3 kills by Megan Coven, 2 by Nagata. And that's how this one will begin. Off the top of the nets and towers. Starts off with an ace, 1-0 cap. Kelsey Towers, who's 5'7", but they tell me she plays like she's 6 feet tall, the bulldog of the team, and here she comes. That big brace on her right leg. Wrap around for Cooper, will just tip it over. Somebody touched the net. It's the Blues that touched it. And it's 1-1. Back to serve now, is Kara Williams. Williams has pretty much played every single point of this tournament so far. Coven will just send it over. Send it in a perfect spot as well. Picked the back corner where nobody was patrolling. McBride tried to get there, but just a little too late, and it's 2-1 Blues. And the veteran Coburn will go back to serve. Coburn will toss it up. Here she comes. And that one will be misbumped, mispassed, but Matsui tracks it down. And now the Blues will go to work on the free ball in the middle, dug by McBride. Here's Kidd, off a block and down, Chelsea McBride. In her final PacWest match. Been so strong. Now Matsui back to serve. Matsui had a nice string of serves in that opening set. Nice pass by Gatto. Here's Nagata. Nagata off a block and down. And back to serve, Humason. Matsui. Good save by Kidd right in front of our table. Here's Kidd again. Kidd down the line, off the arms of Humiston. Back to serve now is Cooper. Cooper off the top of the net. Nice play by Gatto. Pardon me. Yeah, that is Gatto. Cooper with another nice pass. That's just McBride, and McBride gets the kill in front of a diving Coven. And it's 4-3 Cascade. Serve, good pass by Nagata. Lucas in the middle, but it's rejected there. Sedona Arabski. Sedona, named after the city in Arizona, Sedona, Arizona. Mentioned this on Thursday. I love that name. 5-3. Off Nagata for an ace. 6-3. The Blues looking to rebound now. Cascades want to continue to pour it on. Here's the serve. Cooper off the arm. Another ace. A light burn will come in for Gatto. Seven, three, and this one into the net. Back to the Blues, Daphne Kung. Played a lot in that quarterfinal. We didn't see her a lot yesterday. She's got a bandage now, her tape on her left knee. As McBride just sends it over. In the middle, Lucas off a block and down. 7-5. It also looks like she has some tape on that left thumb. Being held together with tape right now is Daphne Kung. Here she comes. This one into the net. 8-5 Cascade. Demules will have a seat. King will check in. And back to serve, Chelsea Kidd. Here's Kidd. Backed up and an ace. During the timeout, I had the chance to check out the Miracle Season filmed in 2018 where Chelsea Kidd was an extra. She's not listed as a cast member, which is too bad, but must have been fun being an extra in that movie. And here she comes. Great volleyball player. Maybe a nice little actress on the side as well. Matsui with a nice dig. As Arabski off the top of the net. Towers keeps it alive. And now it's COVID from the backcourt. She'll just tip it over. Kidd will send it backwards to Matsui. And now McBride. COVID with a nice pass. In the middle for Lucas, tipped. Another tip there. That one by Williams. And Nagata off a block. Good play by McBride with the lefty to keep it alive. Nagata rejected. Williams with a big block there for UFV. And it's 10-5, and now a timeout by the Blues. I haven't had a chance to talk to Chelsea Kidd about how long she was on the set for of the Miracle Season, what she did, but being an extra would have been a lot of fun. The movie stars Helen Hunt and William Hurt as well. So a couple of big names there. I wonder if she got a chance to meet the great Helen Hunt. That would have been a thrill. Obviously, it was shot down here on the Lower Mainland. No, just scrolling through the cast members, and I don't see Chelsea Kidd's name. At least, not yet. Maybe there is a future in acting for Chelsea after her volleyball career is done here in the PacWest. Chelsea, 5'10", native of Surrey, graduate of Clayton Heights Secondary, and soon a graduate of University of the Fraser Valley. Our first match of this championship Saturday, the men's bronze medal match will be next. It's the Douglas Royals against the VIU Mariners, the top two seeds on the men's bracket playing for bronze. And then we get into the gold matches. Women's will be first at 5:30, number one VIU, taking on number two Commotion. And then on the men's side, the number three Capilano Blues taking on the number four Commotion Chargers. That's at 8:00 this evening. Towers will chase it down. This one going to go into the scorer's table. And it's 11-5. The Cascade opening up a six-point advantage now. And now a couple of subs coming in for Capilano. The first will be Kate Sykes coming in for Kung. And also Maya Griffith will come in for Kelsey Towers. So Rob Gowan looking to go to the bench to provide a spark plug, perhaps. And Kidd will go back to serve. Here comes Kidd. Her serve is going to be in the back corner and gets the ace. Kidd seeing that the defenders of the Blues just creeping up a little too far and hit the back corner beautifully. And now Gatta will come in. That ball ended up behind it, Nagata, who is in that right corner. See if she goes there again. She does. This time Gatto gets the pass. In the middle, Lucas comes flying through, tips it over. Wrap around, Arabski dug by Coven. Here's Griffiths, the lefty, and she goes long. Might take Griffiths a point or two to get her feet under her after coming off the bench, didn't see any action in the first set. And some of these players that come off the bench haven't done anything since warm-up. And now Kidd back to serve again. Second team All-Star this season in the PacWest, and here she comes. That pass, a tough one to handle. Coven will tip it up, and now over, courtesy of the block. Backcourt, this is Kidd, she's rejected into the scorer's table. In favor of UFV, and again, the Blues want to take a timeout. This game is getting a little bit out of hand now at 14-5. Cascade, remember, winning the first set. 25-15 was the score in the opening set. As both teams will talk it over, the final match of their seasons will be at Capilano next weekend, well, starting on Thursday for the basketball provincial championships. First games will open up on Thursday. I believe 1:00 start will be the opening game on Thursday in the women's bracket. Basketball wrapping up today in the PacWest. Three games on the women's side, three games on the men's side. The only team not playing this weekend, the Douglas Royals. We happen to be here right now. A lot of the basketball players around the Royals organization and school are volunteering this weekend for this volleyball championship, which I think is great. The men's Royals, we finished the regular season in the top spot. The women are the third seed going into the next weekend's championship. The women will take on Okanagan College out of Kelowna in their opening game on Thursday. As we're back to action here, Lucas is rejected there. McBride looks like she got a hand on it. Arabski was also there, but they give the credit to McBride for the stuff. Although went off the block and out of bounds, so the point goes to Capilano. And Nagata will go back to serve. Matsui with a nice pass to Williams. Arabski skies and gets it down. Arabski jumping basically over the block of Lucas. Got the ball over her along with Griffith. Gets down and it's a point back to UFV, and now some sweat on the floor. Will have to be wiped up by Nagata. With the score, 15-6. And back to serve will be Kristen McBride. Talked to McBride before the season. Hopefully you saw the PacWest Spotlight feature on the website, but she's gotten into pickleball. One of the other players, she wouldn't name the other player that went with her to pickleball, but she said she classifies herself as a good pickleball player. Double hit, charge to the Blues. And now the lead is 10, 16-6. That's a sport I haven't played yet, pickleball. Here's McBride. This one, Sykes can't get to. And McBride will continue her serving. 17-6. Capilano's passing has gotten away from them in this set. As Lightburn will check back in as the libero. 17-6. McBride. That's Coben. A better pass from Megan. Here she comes now. We'll tap it over. Matsui is there. Here's Kidd. Lightburn with a nice pass. Here's Griffiths off a block. Kidd with a nice one-handed dig. Here's Matsui now. Matsui with a kill. And now it's finally down. 17-5. And the pickleballer, McBride, will go back to serve, but first a substitution as Coven will depart. And into the ballgame comes Courtney Mueller. Second time we've seen her this bronze medal match. Second year player out of Langley Christian, as a matter of fact. Where's number four for the Blues, and she's ready, and so are the Blues. Here comes McBride, right to Mueller. Nice pass by her, now Griffiths. Griffiths off a block and down. And now another substitution for the Blues as Lucas will leave. And into the game comes Samantha Wright, a rookie from Timberline Secondary in Campbell River. 5'9", and ready to go. Here she comes, down 18-7. Gets the serve over, nice pass by McBride. Here's Matsui off the block, and then an arm, and out of bounds, and 19-7. The Blues have no answer for this Cascade onslaught right now. And Wright will quickly depart, Lucas back in, and then she'll check out for the libero, Lightburn. Another substitution for the Blues. And they say, no, you'll have to wait, Hannah Shellamy. I'm sure she'll come in the next stoppage. Arabski back to serve. Here she comes, her serve. Mueller, tracked down by Sykes. Here's Mueller now, she'll just tip it over. Kidd is there. In the middle, Cooper off the block. Lightburn chases that one down. Sykes goes backcourt now, and that's Nagata. And now a pair of subs. First, UFV will be awarded a sub as Ashley Hubers will come in. Second year player out of Abbotsford, and McBride will have a seat. And on the Capilano side, Hannah Shellamy will enter the game. First time we've seen her this tournament. Second year player out of Gibson, British Columbia. And Griffith, the southpaw, will head back to the service line. Here she comes. This is off the net. Nice dig by Demules. And off a block and down, courtesy of Matsui. 20-8. Cascade running away with this one. And back to serve will be Kara Williams. Williams with the serve. Handled there by the Blues. Wrap around, Huberson says ace. She gets the kill. Right between the blockers, and it's 20-9. Mueller back to serve after her pregame Coca-Cola. She delivers. Hubers with the pass to Williams, who tracks it down. Here's Kidd. Kidd off a block and down. Blues having all sorts of issues stopping the hitters for the Cascade, including Kidd and Matsui, who's now back to serve. Arabski also has been involved in the scoring. And here's the serve. They set up Shelmy. Shelmy's first attempt of the tournament, and it's down for a kill. So she gets on the score sheet, does the second-year player, Hannah Shelmy, wears lucky 13. And now another couple of substitutions, it looks like, for the Blues. Coming into the game, Amy Tilly. She'll bring out Lucas. So Tilly in the game, and it looks like she's the only sub. The substitution, not exactly correct. I'm not sure now Lucas is back in the game, and now the referees will talk things over. A yellow card now issued to Capilano, a warning. Not exactly sure what happened there. Tilly came into the game for Lucas. Lucas came in for the libero and then came out for the substitution of Tilly and then the substitution right back. Anyway, Lucas in the game officially, and it's 21-10. In favor of the Cascade. Humiston off the tape and down! Just like she drew it up. 21-11. And now a substitution for UFV as Haley Poyer will come in. Poyer will come in and Williams will sit down. I think the first time this tournament Williams is out of the game. Poyer, a rookie out of Saskatoon. Went to the Sweet 16 last year, March Madness. And she'll track this one down, Poyer will. And that's Humers, but will go out. Too long for Humers. And it's 21-12, Capilano trying to fight their way back. And back to serve is Humiston. Humiston standing in that left-hand corner, here she comes. Will just tap it over, Kid plays it. Backcourt, Matsui thought about it and then just bumped it over on the free ball. Mueller will play it there. Shelmy. Shelmy didn't get it over the net and it'll be a four-hit call on the Blues. Lightburn checks back in as the libero. Humiston will have a seat. Arabski also back into the game. The match for the Cascade and Alicia Cooper will go back to serve. Cooper. Mueller can't handle that one, but Shelmy will track it down. And now a free ball sent over by the Blues. Poyer setting up Arabski. Mueller handles that one. In the middle, Lucas will tip it over. Nice dig by Poyer, but it goes out of bounds. Great job by Lucas just to hang in the air, just a touch longer. And got the tip over. 22-13. The VIU men's team now has entered the gym, getting ready for their bronze medal match against Douglas coming up next. Hubers, Mueller will send it right back. Back for Kidd, down the line, and a big kill by Chelsea Kidd with no blockers up. 23-13. The number four, Cascade. Up by 10 with Chelsea Kidd back to serve. Here comes Kidd. In the middle, rejected. Arabski got up for the block. Here's Griffiths now, she'll try. Demules with a dig and then down on the ground goes the ball and it's 23-14. Arabski with another big stuff. But the Blues able to compose and keep the ball with them. And Shelmy will go back to serve for the first time in this tournament. Shelmy to Matsui. Chased down by Poyer. And that's Kidd off a block. Lightburn is there. Off the net. Sykes plays it. Lucas sends it over. There's a tip by Poyer. Nice play by Poyer, the rookie. 5'10" setter. All sorts of height on Poyer. That must have been a cool experience last year, going to the Sweet 16, part of March Madness. How fun would that be? Here's Hubers now. Bumped up by Mueller in the middle for Lucas, who punches it over and gets it down, avoiding set point. And Lucas back to serve, trailing 24-15. Capilano needs to put a string together to get back into this one. Here's Lucas. Her serve is going to go long. And that's how this one will end, with UFV taking another set, 25-15, just like they did in the opening set. So the Cascade up 2-0. We'll go to the third set. The Blues fighting for their season now. It's the Blues and the Cascade live at the 2020 PacWest Volleyball Championship. To the third set we go of this women's bronze medal match. The Cascade comfortably in front right now, 2-0. The Blues' season now on the line. As they'll try to win this one, I would suspect, for Megan Coven in her fifth and final year. Here is Coven, a little tip. But Williams is there. Here's Chelsea Kidd, rejected. Humiston and Coven up for a big block there. And it's 1-0 Blues. After two sets, it's Arabski leading all attackers, 7 kills. 5 by Chelsea Kidd, 5 by Matsui. Towers delivers the serve. This one tipped and in. Nice job by Matsui there. Matsui now 6 points for her. On the Blues side, 4 kills for Lucas, 4 for Coven, 4 for Nagata. Fairly even there. Balance scoring for the Blues, they just haven't had a lot of it. Coven, Humiston, now this is Kung. Kung will send it over, and this will go out of bounds. And the Blues take a 2-1 lead. For the Blues to come back in this one, they will have to score early and try to get a lopsided victory to get some confidence back going into the fourth set, if they can push it that way. 2-1 the score now. This is Coven. Coven will send it over. Matsui with a nice pass. Here's McBride. And it hit the antenna. McBride's attempt at his antenna. Now it's 3-1. Blues and Coven back to serve. Megan Coven has started four of the five positions over the course of her five-year career with Capilano. Graduate of Argyle Secondary, and this one into the net. And the assistant coach, Cal Wolford, of the UFV Cascades, was the head coach at Capilano when he recruited Megan Coven. And he said to me before the game, this might be a tough one to watch Megan start her career at Capilano, now finish her season, her career, 5 years later. He's the only player on this team that he brought in. He told me that he helped recruit Kelsey Towers, the setter, but left before she actually got to Cap. And he's sitting over there on the Cascades bench. Humiston, that serve goes way long. Cal's going to try to coach in Finland, he tells me, next year. Sending in a resume, as a matter of fact, later today or tomorrow to a team, a club team in Finland. He'll try to coach there, bring his family over. And his 11-year-old daughter, that must be fun. Taking the family overseas for a couple years, coach volleyball, give the kids some life experiences. Here's Kung. Kung is rejected. Arabski with a huge block there. Nothing more valuable, though, than real-life experiences. It's tough when you come across people that have never been anywhere, never done anything, never moved anywhere. Don't have that life experience. And you could tell. 4-4 now. Lightburn with a nice pass to Towers. Towers will send it over to Nagata. Nagata off a block. King is there. Here's McBride off a block and down. McBride with a kill, and it's 5-4. Cascade with the lead. Cal said he comes back. I said, well, are you going to get back into coaching again? Maybe see in the PacWest? He said he might get into reffing. Too old to coach, he says. I don't know about that. Nice job by Nagata to send it over. Towers will make it official over the nets, and here comes Arabski off a block and down. So officially, at least for the time being, this will be the final time we see Cal Wolford in a PacWest gym. As he'll head over to Finland. Going there to be an assistant, I guess, later on this year. And hoping to land a head coaching role. 6-4 Cascade. Towers in the middle. This is Lucas, takes it, throws it over. On the back door, Arabski couldn't quite hang long enough to send it over. Now that wraparound has worked so many times for pretty much every match I've seen in this tournament. This time, just a little mistimed. And it falls on the Cascade floor, which means the Blues get a point, 6-5. Capilano trailing with Kung going back to serve. Here she comes. McBride, tough pass. Matsui handles it, tries to get it back up to Kristen. She sends it over. Lightburn is there. Towers chases that one down, and now Coven. Here's Williams over to McBride, off the block of Towers, dug by Lightburn. Here's Coven from behind the attack line, but she went over the attack line. Tried to keep her feet on the other side, just couldn't quite do that. And it's a violation, 7-5. Cascade with the lead now. And McBride back to serve. Here she comes. Tough pass, but Coven will track that one down. Tries to get to Nagata. Does. Nagata goes long. And now it's 8-5. So the Blues started hot in this one, but have cooled off considerably. And now the Cascade have a three-point lead. The serve. Nagata chased down by Towers here. Tries to get it back to Eva. Does. Eva down the line. That's been there for the Blues. We'll try to go back to it again if I'm Capilano. And it's 8-6. Eva Nagata. Part of the all-rookie team this season for the Blues, and here she comes. Good pass by Kidd. That one's sent a little too long. Arabski tried to get it down. She couldn't. And it's 8-7. They got it back to serve again. Here's the serve into the net. 9-7. Cooper enters the game as Demules will have a seat for UFV. And Arabski back to serve now. In that left-handed corner with those bright green shoelaces. And here she comes. And Nagata can't handle it. It's an ace for Arabski and a 10-7 lead. Arabski tells me she's a high-level dancer. Doesn't specify what kind of dance, but she can move. Nagata sends it up to Towers, and Lucas reaches back and sends the ball over and gets a point. Nice athletic play by Jalen Lucas. And Lucas will tee things up. Lucas, Cooper, and now Matsui. Matsui into the net. And the Blues cut the lead to 10-9. Jaylene Lucas, her Instagram account, they call me Jay. And Jay will go back to serve, and here she comes. DeMules with a nice pass to Williams. Pass over here to Matsui, will tip it over. Coven is there. Backcourt, Nagata. Nagata rejected by Cooper. Blues still have it. This is Coven down the line. Great dig by McBride. Now sent over by DeMules. Here's Towers. Sends it to Coven. DeMules with another dig. Now Matsui will try her luck. Nagata with a dig. Kung with a save. Towers will send it over. What a rally here. Matsui, another tip. And down. Towers just reached back, maybe ill-advised, but when you're in the heat of the moment, it's hard to think, oh, maybe I shouldn't. But she had two players behind her. Kung and Coven were there. But what a rally that was. Here's Williams. Williams into the net. And it's 12-10. And DeMules will come back in as King will depart, and Kelsey Towers will go back to serve. Towers coming into this match, 61 assists through the tournament. She's got a handful more here in this match. McBride off the top of the net. This is Matsui down the line, but out. Ties it at 11. And Towers in that huge brace on her right leg. Obviously some sort of surgical procedure on Towers, needing that brace. Off the net and down. Towers gives the Blues a 12-11 lead. Looking at Coach now, Rosima, seeing if she was going to call a timeout or not. She elects not to. And Towers will go back to serve again. Here she comes. There's an ace! Towers in front of McBride. 13-11. Now Rosima will call a timeout. And the Blues have a 13-11 lead and momentum as they come off the floor. A little bit more energy now. The Cascade reeling, but they are still up 2-0. Winning both the first and second set by the score of 25-15. And we keep our eye on Megan Coven and also Chelsea Kidd and Cassidy King as their PacWest careers could come to an end in the next few minutes or so. If the Cascade can pull this one off, sweep the Blues, and then that'll be it for these fifth-year veterans. It's interesting, you always talk to some of these fifth-year student-athletes, and they say a commonality every single time. It goes by so fast. You remember the first time you walk on the floor with the team, the college level, and then suddenly it's over. You got to soak it in as much as you can, but life gets so busy as a student athlete. And suddenly your college volleyball career is over. That's Kidd. She tips it over in the middle. Himmelson, too long, too wide. And it's 13-12. The Capilano coaches thought that was in, but it was right in front of Rosima, the head coach of the Cascade. And she said, yeah, it was out. And I do agree with her. 13-12, now Matsui. Matsui. Good pass by Lightburn. Here's Coven between a block and down. And 14-12, Blues with the lead. You could see the separation between the two blockers. Coven saw it too, went right in between, and got the kill down, like she has done so many times in her Blue career. Going back to serve now. I wonder how many different jerseys Megan Coven has in her closet from Capilano. There's a kill. Every couple of years, teams change jerseys. I like what the Blues have now with blues across the shoulder, on their right shoulder. That blue is sharp. Here's the serve from Cooper. Kung will track that one down. Here's Coven. She'll send it over and get the point. 15-13. Back to serve. Hamilton. This is Kidd. Kidd in the corner. Coven with a nice one. Here's Nagata. Dug there by McBride. Towers will get it to Nagata. Nagata dug nicely by Demules. Humiston. There's Kidd. Kidd will knock it back. Coven with the dig. Towers will get it to Kung. Kung is rejected. Tapped over by Erbsky. And now sent long. Demules is there. Here's McBride. Dug by Humiston. And now a double hit. Blues with the lead. And back to serve goes Chelsea Kidd. Kidd going through her pre-serve routine. Here she comes. Coven with the nice pass to Towers in the middle. Lucas will throw it down. And the return pass goes out of bounds by Kidd. And it's 17-14. Kung back to serve now. 5'9", Daphne Kung, a rookie for the Blues. Here she comes, this one way out. Obviously a miss hit, as you could see that high arcing serve. Didn't quite snap the wrist or get it off the right part of the hand. And way too long. 17-15. Here's the serve by McBride off the top of the tape. And down for a point. Cuts the lead to one. McBride. Here comes McBride. Good pass by Nagata this time. Towers handles it. Nagata will punch it over, but rejected there. Towers will send it deep. Good idea. McBride, however, chases it down. Here's Matsui. Matsui with a kill! And now a timeout charged to Capilano. Here in the timeout, the Cascade regained the lead 18-17. They held the lead to the Blues, but it's been evaporated with a great play by the Cascade. Matsui leading the charge. And also the service game of the Cascade have been very good in this third set. But we've seen some terrific passing and digging all tournament long from this Blues team until today. It just hasn't been as sharp as it has been. And maybe what Coach Gao said in that timeout will change things around. McBride slamming the ball on the floor, and here she comes. Nagata, that's a good pass to Towers. Eva will get it back, rejected, but it just stuck on the top of the net. Enough time, and then Lucas will send it down. I was going to say, just enough time for Nagata to come back down, pop the ball back up for Towers, and then Lucas puts it home and ties it at 18. And Eva Nagata will head back. Speaking Faroese. Here she comes, also can speak English. That one in the stands, Arabski, boy, you hold your breath if you're Coach Rosima. That's the rookie of the year heading full tilt towards the bleachers, trying to get a loose ball in a bronze medal match. And she stopped short, thankfully. And it's 19-18. Doesn't have to be the rookie of the year, you just hope everybody's safe out there. This one, an over bump, two-handed slam by the Blues. And they get it back now. In the middle, Lucas. Lucas just inside the sideline with a little tip. And it's 2018. The Blues trying to extend this bronze medal match, and now the Cascade will call a timeout. Blues doing everything that they can to extend this to a fourth set and then perhaps beyond as well. The Cascade, who won the first two sets, 25-15, would like nothing more to end it here. Give the Blues a little bit of breathing room, a little bit of momentum, and things can change in a hurry. Lead is just two, though. It's 20-18. Blues with the lead. And coming up next at around 3 o'clock, we will see the men's bronze medal match between the defending PacWest champion, VIU Mariners, taking on the top seed in the tournament, the Douglas Royals. Disappointing five-set loss yesterday. The Mariners were also involved in a five-set loss. It was interesting yesterday in the semis. On the women's side, both matches ended in a three-set sweep. Both men's matches ended in a five-set thriller. And we'll see how the Royals and Mariners respond after heartbreaker last night in their semifinal matches. Out of the timeout, Eva Nagata will go back to serve, and here she comes. Pass by McBride. They're going to set up Matsui with a kill. Amanda Matsui, who's done that so many times during the regular season, gets another one here in the postseason. And it's 20-19. Cooper back in the game for the Cascade. Back to serve, Arabski. And here she comes. Into the net. So a service error. And Demules will quickly pop up, check in as the libero. And now a substitution. Jaylene Lucas will come out of the game, and Mueller will check in. Courtney Muller will set up shop behind that service line. And here she comes. The serve handled there by the Cascade, and they'll send it over on a couple of nice plays. That first pass wasn't very good. Here's Coven, who tips it over. Kidd is there. Now Matsui without a block. Doug by Kung, and then they'll have to send it over, but a four hit. Charge to the Blues. And now Lucas will pop right back up and sub in for Mueller. And then Lucas will depart in favor of Lakeburn, the libero. 21-20. Great play by the Cascade to keep that ball alive and send it over. Lakeburn with a pass to Towers. Towers with a tip and gets it down. Towers with a sneaky tip, and it's 22-20. She just seems to pick the perfect time to be able to do that. Just a second-year setter, maybe learning a little bit from the Blues setter on the men's side. Simon Friesen, a two-time All-Star. All-Canadian. Here's Kidd. Kidd a tip, but Coven is there. Towers, quick set. That is going to be a lift call on Cooper. Humiston. And now Ashley Huber is coming back into the ball game for UFV. And McBride will have a seat. 23-20 Blues with the lead. 2 points away from sending this to a fourth set. There's Towers. DeMules with a pass. Back door. Matsui with a tip. Kung is there. Now Coven. Coven off a block. Towers keeps it alive. And down. Cascade with the point. 23-20. 23-21 now. And Matsui back to serve. Good pass, so key here for Capilano. Here's the serve. Pass off the net. Towers plays it nicely. Coven will send it over. Free ball for the Cascade, looking to take advantage. That's Kidd, dug by Nagata with a one arm. Here's Kung. Kung off a block, sent over by the Blues. Cascade will go to work. In the middle, scrambling, Kung will send it over. Cooper keeps it alive. Here's Hubers off the block. King is there, somebody on the net. It's the Blues. And they knot it. 23-22, now first a timeout called by Capilano. 23-22. Some scrambly play, but also keeping the ball up in the air. Both teams doing a great job getting to those loose balls. Any ball that seems to be tipped off a block, there's two or sometimes three players there to try to dive for it. They know what's at stake. This bronze medal match, you either go home with a medal or go home with nothing. And Capilano down two sets to love. The Cascade looking to climb back in this one and then end it in three. Capilano wants to extend it obviously to four and then potentially five. Now a substitution, Hubers will come back out for the Cascade and McBride will check back in. And Matsui back to serve. Trailing by a point. Matsui will tee it up, and here she comes. Kung with a pass to Towers. Nice play by Towers, and Kung just punches it over somehow. Now McBride off a block, and they tie to 23. Here's the serve by Matsui, and that is an ace. And now it's bronze medal points for the Cascade, 24-23. Matsui looking to close the door here. Matsui serve. And that's it. It's an ace, and the Cascade win PacWest bronze with a three-set sweep over the Capilano Blues. Congratulations to both schools making it this far. But it's the Cascade that leave with a bronze medal. The Blues drop the bronze for just the second time in the last six seasons, as they were making their sixth straight appearance in this bronze medal match. And now a nice embrace there from Chelsea Kidd and Megan Coven as their PacWest careers come to a close. Cassidy King as well, as the two teams cross in front of the scorer's table, shaking hands. And Matsui, the hero, just crossing now, getting to the coaches, and now high fives by the Cascade, who win in four sets, beating the Connor Avalanche in four in the quarterfinals, losing the VIU yesterday, played them tough despite some of the scores, and then come right back and sweep the Blues in this one. They win 25-23, then we'll have the players of the match. For the Capilano side, I believe they're gonna give it to Megan Coven. Coven in her final PacWest match. And for UFV, you could give it to Matsui. You could go with just a handful of players. Chelsea Kidd was good.
Director for PacWest Volleyball Provincials,
they'll make the
Spencer
announcement
Harris.
Now. And then the medals will be handed out as well.
The player of the game for Capilano University, number 7, Megan Coven.
And Megan Coven is the player of the match for the Blues in her final PacWest match.
Player of the game for the University of Fraser Valley Cascades, number 3, Sedona Arabski.
And Sedona Arabski gets the nod for the UFV Cascades. Another great choice. The PacWest Rookie of the Year. And a first-team All-Star in Coven. So a couple of very good choices there as they get their picture taken. And for Coven, for King, and for Kidd, what's going through their minds right now as their career comes to a close? Now, we might see them on the bench as a coach, as we so often do. As once a player calls it a career, they still have some academics they need to do the following year, and then they help out any way that they can, including helping coach. And they'll start handing out the hardware to the UFV Cascades. While we do that, we'll let the PA announcer take over. And you can watch the medal ceremony here from Douglas. We'll be back with the men's bronze medal coming up at 3 o'clock. You've been watching the 2020 PacWest Volleyball Championship.
Number 5, Chelsea Kidd. Number 6, Sarah Brownlee. Number 7, Kristen McBride. Number 8, Stephanie DeMules. Number 9, Amanda Matsui. Number 10, Ashley Huberts. Number 11, Cassidy King. Number 13, Haley Poyer. Number 14, Lexi Edwards. Number 15, Kara Williams. Number 17, Lauren Poyer. Head coach, Janelle Rosema. Assistant coach, Cal Wolford. Assistant coach, Jody Mosigal. Assistant coach, Brian Ward. Head athletic therapist, Grant Amon. And student therapist, Gabriel Jensen. Congratulations to the University of Fraser Valley Cascades.
Suffer.